Hey guys, welcome back to Brittany Made It, season 2, episode 2. Just want to say thank you. Thank you for coming back. We're going to be cooking my spaghetti squash. Shout out to my best friend, Michelle, who is always asking me, why don't I film this? So homegirl, this is for you. I am going to be making the spaghetti squash for you. So yeah, let's go ahead and get started. We're going to make a pizza spaghetti squash, and then you're going to also have another option of a like garlic butter, Parmesan cheese instead of the noodles, so you don't feel so bad. You can have that as well. So I'm gonna make two. I'm gonna make them at the same time. It's hot. You see my hair is pulled back. So yeah, I'm just gonna cook and let's get started. All right, guys, so to have your spaghetti squash, you're gonna need spaghetti squash. Puncture holes inside, put it in the microwave, and then wait to slice it. And then you're going to cut it in half, and then I'll show you how to scoop it out shortly. But that's the key ingredient. For the pizza, pepperoni, fresh mozzarella and cheddar, provolone, and more mozzarella. Gonna make these really cheesy. Pizza sauce. And then you can have your seasonings that you can sprinkle into your spaghetti squash. Next recipe. And that's going to take some Parmesan cheese, parsley, 4 tablespoons of butter, some minced garlic. For the garlic Parmesan spaghetti squash, you're going to add some vegetable broth, and I'll show you why I will need this. We're going to go ahead and get started. So I already prepared one. I'm going to show you how to cook both with one. So what you'll do is, I'll put it on here to make it easier. So I'm going to go ahead and split it open, and it has seeds inside. So you're just going to scoop out the seeds. Scoop out the extra stuff that you don't need. You definitely don't want to be biting into seeds. I've like tried to cook these different ways and cut corners and definitely bit into some seeds, and that's annoying when it takes up all your flavor. I love making this. This literally lasts me so long during the week. Like, it's so much food. And the way that I'm gonna cook it is not normally a way that I would, but my grandmother kind of cooks hers this way. She doesn't always eat it in a full form. Like, I usually keep mine as a boat, but she'll shred hers. And so I told her I was going to try it that way next time. All right, guys. So I'm going to start with the pizza spaghetti squash, okay? Because I have to put it in the oven. And then while that's baking, I'll start the garlic parm. So I'm going to get your olive oil. And you're gonna sprinkle it, just like kind of drizzle it, just to loosen it up. Kind of like, you know, just let it run through. Like for all my girls who grease their scalp, that's how it feels. Gonna go ahead and do that. And then you can get your pepper. Of course, everything needs salt and the pepper. Salt. Okay. And I'm gonna do a little garlic powder. Okay, and then I'm done with that. I'm going to flip it over face down. Okay. Face down. All right. I'm going to put that in the oven for like 10, 15 minutes because you already put it in the microwave, so it's like slightly cooked. But you're gonna put it in the oven at 375, okay? Gonna go ahead and place that in there. So now we're going to start with the garlic noodle parm, but it's squash. All right, so you're gonna scrape it. Scrape. You see how it's coming out like spaghetti. So I did put this in the microwave to loosen it up, but it didn't quite get all the way through. So I am going to add this one to the oven as well, just to loosen it a little bit more. So I'm going to do the same thing that I did to the other ones. I'm going to do the olive oil, salt and pepper, and just have that loosen up, and I'm going to put it in there for about 10 minutes, 12 minutes. And so, yeah, I'll be right back. Okay, so I just took out the one for the pizza. I had to keep in the other squash because it's not quite ready. So you take this out. It's really hot, y'all, so be careful. But you just kind of like loosen it up. A little seed. Okay, so you see the noodles. See the noodles forming. So you're not going to break it down too much. That's just to loosen it up even more. So you're going to get your pizza sauce. And you're going to scoop it in. Okay? Get your pizza sauce and just scoop it in. Okay. And I'm not big on like measurements, obviously. Like, it's really up to you and your taste. Like, that's one thing I'm not gonna be able to stress enough. I'm not crazy about salt. Like, I don't like to add a whole lot of salt to my food. I'd rather you add salt to yours. But you know, some people don't think that way, and there's nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with it. But at this point, I just need to make sure, because I've tried this recipe so many times, and it's like, I should have done it this way. I should have done it this way. So I said the next time I would do it this way. And I feel like it'll be so much better. Grab my pepperoni, and I'm going to line the inside just a little bit. I'm going to put like 6. In each. Okay. Get your provolone and mozzarella and sprinkle that on the inside. You can add as much cheese as you like. Couple of recipes that I saw say like 2 cups of the cheese. Girl, do what you want to do. You know what you like. Okay. A little more mozz and cheddar. Okay. And then I'm going to add pepperoni on top. So I'm going to go ahead and put these in the oven for about 15 minutes just to melt everything. You can kind of eye it. You don't have to cook it too long, but you kind of just want all the flavors to go. So gonna put that in, and I'm going to check on my other one for the pasta. And that's good that it's running out. That means your sauce got all the way through, so that's gonna be amazing. All right, guys, so we're back, and I shredded all of my spaghetti squash, and look at how much came out. Don't worry, this is not all just for me, but yes. Look at how much, like, that's amazing. your spaghetti squash should look stressed out like this. Stressed, okay? I'm going to go ahead and just add a little salt and pepper. A little parsley. Just all the way through. You have a lot of noodles. Okay? Let's go ahead and mix that in. All right, so turn your fire on low. And I've already added into my pot here. I've added the minced garlic. And then you're gonna, I would say three cloves or how much garlic you like, but don't be having it all out your pores. But yes, garlic. And then you have the 4 tablespoons of butter. So that's just on low right now. All right, so I'm just letting that sit, and then I'm going to add the vegetable broth. You're gonna do 1/4 for the vegetable broth. Ooh, our pizza is ready. Let that sit for a little bit. Yep. I'm going to add all of the spaghetti squash in here. So you're just gonna just let this heat up. Okay. It smells good, y'all. Let's get our pizza. So good. And then you got your secret pepperoni in there. Looks amazing. It's still cooking. So this is gonna last me. You can honestly cut this in half if you wanted to, and that's 4 days. Or that's lunch and dinner. Or lunch and dinner, whatever you want to do. This stuff is going to last you so long. It's ridiculous. Always have leftovers like forever. I want to add a little more parsley. Turn this off, and I'm going to add my Parmesan, okay? You can kind of fold that in. I'm going to go ahead and put this in a bowl. Oh my goodness. Oh. My gosh, sheesh. And remember, this is veggies and cheese. Nothing wrong with that. Spin this up, twirl it. Ooh. Okay. It kind of tastes like bougie noodles. Bougie cup of noodles, but it's so good. This is really good. I would probably like add meat. Like if you want like steak or something on the side, I would see this as like a side dish. Side dish. But yeah, this is bomb. Really good. To the pizza. Look at that. I cut it in half. Wow. Looks so good. I told somebody that they can have this for dinner. Let somebody be the taste tester. It tastes just like pizza, but like spaghetti.
Ew.
But like spaghetti. You wanna try it, girl?
Bomb.
Don't be fooled. You still eat vegetables, but they just drenched in everything else. So I guess it really doesn't matter because it's veggies. That's it, guys. We made it. Who made it? Brittany made it. Who made it? Brittany made it. We did it. We made two spaghetti squash. They both take about an hour, realistically, to prep. So simple. This is probably gonna last me about a week. Yeah, about a week. So all day, eat this, you good. Don't have to worry about nothing. It's hot to be cooking every day. Thanks for watching Brittany Made It. Please subscribe, turn on your notifications. Yeah, we're trying to film every week. Next week is a holiday, so you might see me, you might not, but watch my story. I might make something on my story. That's at Brittany Made It, BrittanyMadeIt _. And yeah, I'll see y'all next week, maybe. All right, bye.